In multi-vendor environments, on-premise firewalls, cloud-based firewalls, network security groups, and next-generation firewalls all need to be managed simultaneously. Many organizations still do not manage all these security controls centrally, which is where Tufin comes in. Let's look at the different use cases Tufin addresses within the Microsoft Azure framework. The first use case is audit and compliance. Tufin provides you with the tools to define your own global security policy, such as the corporate matrix we see here. This allows you to define for both the cloud and on-premise devices segmentation zones in which you configure what devices should be communicating with each other to fulfill compliance requirements. For instance, we can see that the traffic from Azure Database Zone should not be allowed to reach the Amsterdam zone on-premise or via a different site. The same is also true from Amsterdam to Site A. But if you look at the traffic from Azure Exchange Zone to Amsterdam site, traffic is only allowed for these specific ports and protocols. This also includes Azure Firewall. For example, we can see why a rule violates a certain regulatory compliance or internal requirement and can then drill down to learn what the compliance requirement is and which firewall rules violated the requirement. Maintaining the theme of audit readiness, here we can see rules that can be optimized, such as rules that are unused across networks and rules found in the Azure NSGs in the network. From here, we can automatically remove these rules, i.e. clean up the policy, and see over time how the number of unused rules is reduced. Tufin also generates built-in reports that can be run periodically to see all the rules without hits across your entire environment, including Azure NSGs, Azure firewalls, and more. You can also leverage security best practices reports based on your compliance requirements to identify easily and quickly all the risky rules across the entire environment. Tufin simplifies network troubleshooting by utilizing an interactive topology map in which the entire Azure environment, including VNets, load balances, express routes, etc., are visible. Here, you can visualize the routes, VPNs, ping information, and understand how these different entities connect to each other and to the on-premise network. Tufin also visualizes traffic flows. Leveraging path analysis to troubleshoot network connectivity, we can insert the source and destination and service, which in our case is ASGs, otherwise known as Application Security Groups, in Azure. From here, Tufin will simulate the path to highlight how the traffic flows, in this case from a certain spoke VNet to the hub VNet, enforced by a checkpoint cluster via the internal load balancer, and then goes into a different spoke. We can also see more specifically what blocks or enables the traffic. In our case, we can see a rule that enables the traffic based on the ASG and see that the checkpoint firewall is blocking the traffic. Tufin can also automate the entire network change progress, including firewalls, network security groups, and more, both on-premise and cloud-based. The first step of the workflow is to enter the access request where we submit which access is required, which can come from any ITSM system such as ServiceNow, Remedy, or Jira. Here we can see an example of a certain application security group that requires access to a different application security group that comes from the on-premise network to the Azure cloud. We can see how Tufin automates steps in the process, including automatically identifying all the firewalls that are relevant for the change request in the path, based on the topology that we just showed before, and what device blocks or enables the traffic for each change request. Tufin also automatically identifies what policies will be affected by the change. We can also run the risk analysis based on the compliance matrix we showed previously to understand whether the requested access is risky for the organization or if it meets regulatory compliance requirements. Here we can see that the requested access is indeed risky. So we have seen how a network access change is designed, showing what should be done in order to implement the requested traffic, what specific changes needed to enable access in the cloud, including NSGs, Azure firewalls, third-party firewalls, or NVAs. Moving forward, we can automatically implement all of these changes, updating the relevant policies directly on Azure.